there has been a report on the missing male, Hank McKenna, age 29, Caucasian, brown hair. Last seen at the Abbott Apartments on Wilson and Grand River. He was wearing a neon orange vest, red shirt, and jeans. If found, or you suspect his whereabouts, please contact the Detroit Police.
Whoa, that's right across the street from our new spot. How do you go missing in a neon orange vest anyways?
Let's just not talk about this. Today is a big day. Today is a good day.
Let's just focus on you and me and getting our very first place together.
Right down the street from where somebody went missing?
Calvin.
I guess, you know, I'm pretty excited that I don't have to wake up to listen to your dad singing in the shower anymore.
You don't like his Bob Dylan impression? How does it feel?
How does it feel? Like a complete unknown.
Like a rolling stone.
But honestly, like, I appreciate them, you know, letting me stay at your house when I was in between jobs, and it was cool, but honestly, I couldn't take one more backhanded comment about me not making any money from your dad.
You know, he means well. Like, he's just taking care of his little princess.
Babe, now that I got my own place, maybe I can get the old high school ska band back together for practice here.
Oh, I'd rather listen to my dad's Bob Dylan.
Well, the Carpet Munchers was a great band.
I mean, we can't be too loud, we have neighbors. Maybe you can join their band.
Well, it's not ska, but I guess it'll do. What the hell are they listening to anyways?
It's not music. Have you never seen this movie? North by Northwest. It's a Hitchcock classic.
Okay. I guess now I know who Spotify we're not listening to while we unpack. I found this chair. Now we don't have to sit on the floor while we eat dinner.
Oh my God, where did you find that? The world's ugliest thrift shop? And what is that? Is that blood?
No, it's probably just a wine stain or something. Oh. For your information, I found this beauty on the corner. It's garbage day. You know, not having a job those 6 months really taught me how to pinch some pennies. Oh, check this out. I found this beauty on Facebook Marketplace. And look, it's rustic and it's vintage. And I think it's a good price too.
Look, I'll fight you on this tomorrow. I'm too exhausted right now. Plus, this fabric is just as loud as our neighbors were earlier.
Why are they doing this?
That's weird. It's like they just heard you.
You know, despite how loud they are, they do have impeccable taste in movies. The birds.
What are you, like 80?
Alright, asshole, let's go eat.
Oh yeah, I didn't even say this. I think now that we have our own space, I think we should probably learn how to cook.
I know how to cook.
Okay, well, if you're referring to that linguine you made us that had us on the toilet a week straight,
how was I supposed to know that chicken isn't supposed to be pink?
Because
for
it's
steak.
Not supposed to be pink.
It's
all right, Tarantino. What movie's that?
It sounded like Psycho. The scream isn't what I remembered. Anyway, it's like 10 p.m., so why are they starting a movie right now?
Yeah. What's with these people?
These are just big movie buffs.
I'm gonna go up there.
Calvin, no, we'll just go up there together in the morning and see what's going on.
Oh
Be nice. Just be nice. These are our neighbors, so just politely ask them to turn down the TV.
You know what? It might be nice if I can get some goddamn sleep.
Again? Seriously? What's wrong with these people?
Hello.
Hello. Hi there. We just moved in downstairs and wanted to introduce ourselves.
Hello.
Hi there. Hello. I'm so sorry to disturb you. We just moved in downstairs. Wanted to come up and say hello. I'm Jill and this is Calvin.
Oh, hello. I am Gloria. You know, I do think that we heard some noises down. Was that you?
Well, these floors are pretty...
I know you mentioned we. Mm-hmm. Do you live here with your family or...
Oh, my husband Willis. Yes, he's over there.
Well, we would love to have you guys over for dinner once we're more settled in.
Oh, why should we wait? I have just made a fresh batch of blueberry muffins. So scrumptious, they're my specialty. Why don't you join us for breakfast?
Actually, we have...
That would be lovely.
Give me just one moment to check with my husband, Willis, to make sure that he's decent.
Well,
just
actually...
Me... One moment, one moment.
That would be lovely.
Oh, goodly. One moment, I'll be right back. Okay, just one moment. Okay.
You didn't even bring up the noise.
Don't be such an asshole. Look how cute she is. How could you be mad at her? Plus, she made muffins.
You invited them over. You don't even know how to cook.
I know how to cook.
I'm ready to come right in. Welcome, welcome.
Let's have a seat right there. This is my husband, Willie, or Willis. I think I'm going to go in the kitchen. Willis, wake up. Talk to our guest. I'm going to go in the kitchen and get the muffins and orange juice. Have a chat with him.
Oh my God, that's the chair.
I thought you were kidding when you said that in the corner.
I wasn't.
I'm sorry. I'm a little hard of hearing. What was that?
Willis, I'm Jill, and this is my boyfriend, Calvin. I am such a huge fan of your home. I love Alfred Hitchcock.
Oh, really? Most people... nowadays, don't appreciate him. He can really transport you to a whole different world.
Well, here we go! Fresh muffins and orange juice. Please help yourselves.
Oh, thank you.
By the way, I do not think that we told you exactly how we met. Do you want to know? Okay, so Willis and I decided one night, didn't we, dear, to take a very romantic drive-in movie, and you know what it was? It was The Birds.
That's incredible. My grandmother and I used to watch those movies all the time together. Brings back a lot of memories.
Really?
I really wish they would do drive-ins more often. I think it's really romantic.
Well, yeah, if you think about it, this last day has been like a drive-in for us. These floors, mm-hmm. They're so thin, so we can hear all the movies that you've been watching.
Hearing all of those movies has been really nostalgic for me.
Oh, well, we are sorry, aren't we, dear? We tend to get a little loud sometimes, and we're not used to people living beneath us. To have a youngster, right, Willis, that is so interested in classic cinema, I cannot tell you how thrilled we are.
Well, hearing you guys all the time, like I hear North by Northwest mm-hmm. playing, brings back memories with my grandmother. And, well, though the one, I think from last night, I didn't recognize. Might have been something I haven't seen or...
You can borrow any of our VHS tapes if you'd like. I don't think we have to worry about them stealing them. We know where you lived.
Well, you know, it's been really good. No, no, none for you. And let's go. It's been really nice meeting you both.
Thank you, guys.
You're very welcome.
Nice
see
you.
See ya. Don't be a stranger.
Yes, we do.
My
name's Louise.
Alright, that's it. I'm gonna go settle this. Hello?
Yo, there's other people trying to sleep in this building.
Calvin, we met earlier.
You Townsend of Missing Men Cup.
I'm your neighbor from downstairs. Hello? Hello?
If we use one of these, we can do the whole Lucy and Edward type of thing.
I was thinking more on the line of Norman Bates. I am going to have to sharpen these there. You know, somewhere around is my knife sharpener. I'm not... Oh, Willis!
Why are you here?
Hey, it's me, Calvin, from earlier, your neighbor.
So you just... barge in.
No, I heard your TV again. It was pretty loud, but don't worry. I can just leave.
Well, dear, as much as you would like that to happen, that is not going to happen today. You see, we feel that you do not have the same affinity for Hitchcock as your lovely Jilly does. So I bet you do not even know what's on the television right now.
No?
Yeah, of course you don't. It's called The Man Who Knew Too Much.
Wayne County Sheriff's Office is asking for the public's help in locating a 24-year-old local man, Calvin Garcia. He was last seen August 13th on Grand River, where witnesses say he was moving into Costello Apartments with his girlfriend, Jill Smith. This is the second missing person's case.
Lean back and enjoy yourself until the coroner comes.